This is an RCA CTC16 chassis that I'm checking the IF alignment on, and this is a very high hour chassis, and it's had the tube sockets all resoldered and the boards are all black under the tube sockets, and I checked the chroma bandpass and it was way off, so I aligned it, and I'm using the BNK 415, and you can pick these up on eBay pretty cheap. But the key here is you have to have the BNK factory probes and connectors that come with this, or it's not worth your time. The input coupling is what you do. You get an old tube shield, you push the mixer oscillator tube back, you push this shield back on the mixer oscillator tube, and then you simply just push this over it. You don't let it touch, you just stick it up there far enough to kind of cover the tube. And this is our coupler that comes with the 415. We've got our two connections, which are, we have our AGC connection here, AGC voltage, which I soldered it to the bottom of the circuit board where it calls, and then we have our detector output right here. This is the detector output. I have a video where I did this on a 35. It's basically the same thing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show, that was in here. Pause this. Okay, so here's what the bandpass looks like as a baseline. And keep in mind, this is what it's supposed to look like. So the center marker right here is 44. And then the ones to the right and left are 42.67 and 45. So those are the two on the sides. And I tried several different tubes in the IF, including brand new out of the box tubes, and it doesn't really affect. It affects the gain a little bit, this, which that right there, what you're seeing is adjusting the AGC voltage. And this is the attenuator, how much you're... So you can see how really far off this was. And the symptom was you couldn't fine-tune this thing real well. It was kind of always up on edge where the text was sparkly. You couldn't get rid of that. So I'm going to try and flatten this out a little bit. So after about 8 minutes of tweaking, here's what I've come up with. And that's our 44 megahertz one in the middle there that was just a big peak before. You just have to keep going back and forth and back and forth and finding which one increases what side of the band, and you just have to get it stagger tuned. And it also, a filter capacitor is kind of taking a dump on me right in the middle of this. The hum has started and you can see this noise in the IF, this ripple. So I'm going to have to figure out what happened there. It's got to be a filter cap. You can hear it humming. Yeah, just keep going back and forth until you flatten it out. Get the bandwidth. Let's take a look at how nice this looks. Let's see if I can't get something up here to kind of block the sun. Um, And it's important to go through a whole bunch of different ranges. This is adjusting the IF voltage. And I'll drive this into overload here. See, we can run the AGC all the way quite the other way instead of going positive with it, go negative. And it's important that it kind of stays consistent through a wide range. And that looks real nice. I gotta just deal with the filter capacitor issue. Okay, so this is feeding in on channel 4. Just to kind of look at the tuner and everything, and we're just feeding into the antenna terminals here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn the fine tuning, and again the center is 44 megahertz when I'm turning on and off, and that looks real good here. I'm going to turn the fine tuning. You can kind of see what the fine tuning does, and the fine tuning looks real nice now. I mean, you can move this thing clear from, by fine tuning I mean the tuner fine tuning. You can move this real nice from one end to the other. Can go through a range of AGC voltages here. A range of signal level. So this looks real good. I'm going to fix the filter capacitor and I'm done with this.
Nutrition, the AV Fusion could have had a V8. A great guest
experience. This has a real nice picture now. The fine tuning works just as it should. Can go from basically black and white to overdrive. This came out real nice. I'd like to say that I believe the IF in this had been tweaked without the proper equipment, because I don't see how it could be that far off. I think someone probably went through and just peaked the gain out, which is something you never do on a stagger tuned IF. They just peaked it for maximum sensitivity, which is a big no-no.